In the previous slide, we have seen the working of a wind turbine. In this slide, we are going to see types of wind turbine. So there are two types of wind turbine. First is horizontal axis wind turbine, and the second one is vertical axis wind turbine. This slide shows the picture of horizontal axis wind turbine and vertical axis wind turbines. We can clearly see that the axis of rotation in this wind turbines is in horizontal position, and the axis of rotation in these turbines are in vertical position. So let's see the horizontal axis wind turbine in more detail. So let's start with horizontal axis wind turbines in a detailed overview. Horizontal axis wind turbines have the main rotor shaft and electrical generator at the top of the tower and may be pointed into or out of the wind. Small turbines are pointed by a simple wind vane, while large turbines generally use a wind sensor coupled with a servo motor. Most have a gearbox which turns the slow rotation of the blades into a quicker rotation that is more suitable to drive an electrical generator. In this slide, we can show the pictures of horizontal axis wind turbines. These type of turbines are mainly used in community areas. These turbines are used in farm areas, and these are industrial level wind turbines. So let's discuss the advantages of horizontal axis wind turbine. Variable blade pace with the turbine blade, the optimum angle of attack. The tall tower base allows access to stronger winds inside with wind shear. High efficiency since the blades always move perpendicularly to the wind, receiving power through the whole rotation. And the most important thing about HAWT are they are self-starting. Disadvantages of horizontal axis wind turbines. Tall towers in blades up to 90 meters are long and difficult to transport. Transportation can cause 20% of the equipment cost. Tall horizontal axis wind turbines are difficult to install and require skilled operators. Massive tower construction and heavy blades are required, and they also require regular maintenance to work properly. So let's discuss vertical axis wind turbines in a more detailed view. A vertical axis wind turbines, also known as VAWT, is a type of wind turbines where the main rotor shaft is set transverse to the wind, while the main components are located at the base of the turbine. This arrangement allows the generator and gearbox to be placed located close to the ground, facilitating service and repair. A vertical axis wind turbine's head is axis perpendicular to the wind streamlines and vertical to the ground. So these are two pictures of vertical axis wind turbines. We can see that axis is vertical and the main parts are at ground level. Advantages of vertical axis wind turbines. They are omnidirectional in nature, that is, accepts wind from any angle. Components can be mounted at ground level, which results in ease of service and lighter weight tower. These are theoretically use less material and capture the same amount of wind. In the previous slide, we have seen advantages of vertical axis wind turbines. In this slide, we are going to see disadvantages of vertical axis wind turbines. The main disadvantages are they have poor self-starting capabilities, and unlike the horizontal axis wind turbines. Also, the centrifugal force stresses blade, which can damage the parts of the wind turbine. However, they have never been commercially successful due to low efficiency. These structures are at low at ground where the wind speeds are lowest, so the power input is low. Hence, the power output is also low. We have discussed about horizontal axis wind turbine and vertical axis wind turbines. So let's move to a new section in which we are going to discuss parts of a wind turbine. This is a short video showing parts of a wind turbine. This is rotor, this is blade, tower, nacelle, and this is blade. So this is the main bearing, this is gearbox, this is yaw mechanism. This is anemometer to calculate the direction of wind. This is heat exchanger and controller. So let's discuss these parts of the wind turbine in a more detailed manner. So there are three main parts of a wind turbine: blades, shaft, and generator. The blades act as barrier to the wind. When the wind flows the blade to move some of the wind energy is transferred to the rotor. shaft. When a rotor spins, the shaft also spins and transforms the mechanical energy into rotational energy. A generator uses a differential electrical charge to produce a change in voltage. Voltage is actually electrical pressure, the force that moves an electrical current. In this section, we are going to discuss a very interesting fact. How much energy is it possible to extract from the wind using a wind turbine? So by calculation, the maximum efficiency of wind turbines can be 59.26%. This is also known as the Batts limit. So let's see the proof of Batts limit. The power output of a wind turbine is the product of four terms: neta T, neta M, neta E, and pressure input. Where neta T is turbine efficiency, neta M is mechanical efficiency, and neta E is electrical efficiency. These three terms, after getting multiplied, also known as CP, also known as overall turbine efficiency. So power output is equivalent to overall turbine efficiency into power input. So let's calculate the Batts limit. Let's take a cylindrical surface, cylindrical volume, in which the velocity of flowing air is V, radius of cylinder is R, and area of cross section is A. The power output is equal to half m dot V square, where m dot is the mass flow rate. Also, m dot is equal to rho AV. So power is equal to half rho AV cube. So let's take the case of the wind turbines. Initially, the pressure of the air is P naught, and the area of cross section is AU, and the velocity of initial wind is VU. This is the area where are the rotors of wind turbines. The velocity at the rotor of wind turbines is of the air is VT, and the cross section of the rotors of wind turbines is AT. Finally, after passing through the rotors, the velocity of the air is equal to VD, and the area of cross section is equal to AD. So the power output is equal to half mass flow rate into change in velocity square. So power is equal to 1 by 2 rho AT VT into VU square minus VD square. This equation we will use in the next slide. By the conservation of mass, area into velocity is equal to constant. So AU VU is equal to AT VT is equal to AD VD. Force is also m dot delta V, mass flow rate into change in velocity. So force is equal to pressure into area, so P1 minus P2 into AT, and m dot is equal to rho AVU, and delta V is equal to VU minus VD. So change in pressure is equal to rho VT into VU minus VD. Also, change in pressure is equal to half rho V square. So by equating both these equations, we get VT is equal to VU plus VD upon 2. This equation we will use in the next slide. From previous to previous slide, we have equation of power is equal to half rho AT VT into VU square minus VD square. From previous slide, we have VT is equal to VU plus VD by 2. So by putting in this equation, we got this equation. So after simplifying it, we got this equation. So we are putting VD upon VU is equal to Z to simplify, to make it less complicated. So power is equal to half rho AT VU cube 1 minus Z square plus Z minus Z cube. So neta is equal to power output upon power input. Power input is equal to half rho AT into VU cube, and power output is equal to this equation. So calculating neta, we get neta is equal to half 1 minus Z square into 1 plus Z. To find maximum efficiency, we are going to differentiate d neta upon dz. So we get two values of z, 1 by 3 and minus 1. Minus 1 is not possible. So by putting 1 by 3 in this equation, we are getting neta is equal to 16 upon 27 or 59.26%. So the maximum efficiency of a wind turbine is equivalent to 59.26%, also known as Batts limit. But in reality, the efficiency is not equal to 59.26%. Commercially utility connected turbines delivered 75 to 80% of the Batts limit. Also, the efficiency depends on various other factors such as weather conditions and the velocity of air. Till now, we have seen the working of a wind turbine, about the bed's limit, and about horizontal axis wind turbines and vertical axis wind turbines. In this section, we are going to see the historical developments in harvesting wind energy. People are using the energy of wind from a long period of time. So let's see in the more detail. Before thousands of years, people have got wind to propel their boats. In the first century AD, first time known in history, the wind driven wheel is used to power a machine. The first known wind turbine used in produce electricity is built in Scotland. It is 1887. This is the picture of world first electricity producing wind turbines built in Scotland. We have seen early era and ni 19th century of wind energy developments. So let's see the 20th century wind energy development. In 1903, wind turbines with fewer blades that spin faster are more efficient than turbines with many blades spinning slowly. This is a discovery that is made in 1903. We are going to see this discovery in detail in the further section. In 1904, the Society of Wind Electricians held its first course on wind electricity. During World War II, German wind turbines are used on German U-boats to recharge submarine batteries to save fuels. In 1980s, Denmark starts setting offshore first offshore wind turbines. We have seen 19th century and 20th century developments of to harvest wind energy. So let's discuss the 21st century or present scenario developments in wind energy. This slide shows country-wise wind energy installation from 2015 to 2019. The first place is of China. China is harvesting 237,000 megawatts of energy from wind turbines. The second number is of United States, which is less than half the amount of China. India is at fourth position in harvesting wind energy around the globe. In the 21st century, India has a primary goal to shift from non-renewable sector to renewable sector. In the renewable sector of India, the 50% share is of wind energy. So wind power generation capacity in India has significantly increased in recent years. As of 29 February 2020, the total installed wind capacity was around 37,000 gigawatts, and it is the fourth largest installed wind power capacity in the world. Wind power is in the spread in India in southern, western, and northern regions. So in the next slide, we are going to see a small introductory video which is telling about wind energy harvesting in India.
Progress in our fast-paced digital age is dragged back by the looming threat of global warming and climate change. One solution we can bank on is switching from high emission, import-based, fast depleting fossil fuels like coal to clean and renewable energy. The Indian government is therefore committed to combat climate change with mainstream renewable like wind, a welcome change for future generations. Wind has been transforming the face of the earth long before humans even existed. Today, humans use wind for change. In India, wind power projects grew steadily after grid-connected turbines came in 1989. From those beginnings, wind is seen as a powerful alternate source to address power demand of the country. Today, India is the fourth largest wind power in the world with 34 gigawatt installed capacity and a potential of 302 gigawatt. With major investments driven by the private sector, a whopping 60% capacity increase showed in just the last 4 years, reflected in the installed power of the 9 wind states in India. At 49%, wind already leads with the largest piece of the Indian renewable energy pie. By 2022, The government aims for 175 gigawatt renewable, with 60 gigawatt going to wind. Perhaps the time has come when the entire world and the country, like India, will be driven by renewable energy such as wind and solar. Wind manufacturers echo the Make in India mantra, powerfully combining 80% indigenization, cutting-edge technology, and R&D centers all over India. This has boosted the economy, creating 2 million jobs where they are needed most, in rural India, possibly touching 5 million by 2042. Over 4,000 MSME wind component suppliers with world-class products and components have pushed exports to over $500 million per annum and a potential growth of over $2 billion. New technology and MNRE policy bolster manufacturers in building India's energy security. The low operating cost of wind makes it an affordable source of power for all. With zero pollution and zero water consumption for generation, wind energy is as clean as it gets. Nature's bounty has truly enabled a clean tomorrow where we can create power from thin air. We are a force of nature. Help us make our future cleaner, greener, and brighter.